This video is sponsored by Next Games, creator of AMC's official game, The Walking Dead No Man's Land. I put a link in the description so you can go download the game for free, and it comes with a special offer I'll tell you about in a few minutes. What's up, guys? Welcome back. For this video today, I thought it'd be fun to take a little bit of an apocalyptic twist. Now, if you're to find yourself in a survival, emergency, or zombie apocalyptic situation, one of the most valuable resources you could get your hands on would be clean drinking water. You won't last very long without it. So for this video today, I thought it'd be great to show you how to use resources you already have to make clean drinking water for yourself. So quick update, guys, I just stepped outside for a second and walked over to my fish pond, which ironically doesn't have any fish in it, but it does have a massive amount of other kinds of life, as you see here. We've got mosquito larvae, we've got these little worms flopping around all over the place, we've got algae, and all kinds of junk and other little parasites that probably won't help very much in your quest for survival. But I am gonna drink it once we make our filter and sterilize the water. We need a simple way to filter all this garbage out before we sterilize the water, and to get started, we're gonna be making a simple sand charcoal filter. Now to get started making our sand charcoal filter, of course we're gonna need some sand, we're gonna need some charcoal, and we're gonna need some kind of a plastic container like these simple little water bottles you probably have lying around. Now because sand, clay, and rocks have different densities, if you put them in a container with water and stir it all up, the rocks will fall to the bottom first, followed by the sand and the clay on top. Any organic material left behind will float up to the surface where you can skim it off, and by using these layers of separation, with one chunk of dirt, you can end up with nice small pebbles, very fine sand, and the clay, which we don't actually need for this experiment. Or you could use something like a strainer and filter out the finer sand that way as well. So now that we've got our fine sand, our small pebbles, and a small water bottle, the only thing left to do is crush up some charcoal. Now for this experiment, I'm using the same charcoal I used for our black powder experiment we made in a previous video. However, if you don't want to go to the trouble of making your own, you can just look around a campfire for those large chunks of black wood that are charred and snap in half when you press them. If your charcoal's done right, it should just about crumble if you apply any kind of pressure to it, which is good because the finer we can get our charcoal, the better our filter is gonna work. Now, of course, my charcoal is just a mixture of small twigs, paint sticks, and sawdust, which I like the sawdust because it's already in fine powder form to begin with. But whatever material you end up using to make your charcoal should be just fine because it all ends up as pretty much the same stuff. The goal is just to make it a very fine powder because the finer your charcoal is, the better your filter is gonna work. That is beautiful. So here we are, guys. We have all of our filter materials prepped and ready for assembly. So let's take our plastic water bottle, cut off the bottom, and put a little bit of paper towel on the bottom to catch everything as it falls in. Now, if you don't have any paper towel or fine cloth, you could use a bit of your shirt, you could use some sock, any kind of cloth, really, that's gonna stick down the bottom and hold the charcoal in place, preventing it from slipping through. So now that we have our paper towel in place, we can go ahead and start adding the filter materials finest to coarsest. So in this case, we're gonna start with the very fine charcoal powder and build that up a few inches deep, followed by as much of the fine sand as we can pack in there, and then a nice top layer of small pebbles. And that's really to protect the system from the water that's splashing in. And just to go one step further, I took the bottom of the bottle and cut it into a makeshift baffle to stick it on the top and help reduce erosion as we pour the water in. Now this is a very basic style filter, and the more material you could add, the better it will work. And you could also get creative with some different variations. For example, you could layer the charcoal and the sand, charcoal sand, as many times as you want. Or you could even just cut the water bottle in half, use the top part of it to form the filter, and use the bottom part to form the cup. The time has come to take our scummy pond water and test our filters to see if it worked. Now, if you look at the water itself, this has been sitting out for about 45 minutes, and you can see that already a lot of the material in there has settled down to the bottom and relatively filtered itself through gravity. We've got organic material and bugs floating at the top, but the water is a lot clearer than it used to be. So step number one in filtering your water, if you can, let your water sit out for a few hours so most of the material can settle down to the bottom first. So I've just made the transfer. You can already see that this water is so much cleaner than this water here. There's still little bugs floating around there and a lot of other nasties, but we can now take this water and pour it into our filter and cleanse it even further. Watch this. So our water filters are charged and it is gonna take a little bit of time for the water to filter through. So while we're waiting for that, let me show you a fun way you can brush up on those crucial survival strategies for surviving that inevitable zombie outbreak. I put a link down in the description to download The Walking Dead No Man's Land. It's a free game with a special offer that's only available right now. Now, if you're the kind of person that likes playing checkers, chess, or turn-by-turn strategy type games, this might be a good choice for you. You actually use the characters you know from the television show The Walking Dead in the actual Walking Dead locations like the Terminus and the prison. When I was doing a road trip down to LA with my friend Mark a few weeks ago, I actually spent 6 hours straight playing this game, so I made it pretty far. So you take turns moving people around, and every time you move, then the zombies get a chance to move as well. So you have to use a little bit of strategy, you have to do some tactical maneuvers, and you have to think your way through it, because if you make the wrong move, all of your hard work can go down the drain. The more cleverly you can position your people, the better your chances at winning. It's a lot of fun, and there's some back-end strategy going on as well, because not only are you defeating the zombies and rescuing humanity, you also get to play around with developing an encampment you start out with, and you can choose how to set it up to build out your colony and fortify it. If you're a fan of the TV show The Walking Dead, you're gonna recognize characters like Daryl, Rick, Michonne, and Negan, which, by the way, if you download the game right now, you'll get the character Negan for free. It would actually be really cool if they could make a Kenny random character. The game's available on iOS, Android, and pretty much any other device. So if you like zombies and you want to rescue humanity, hang out with characters you know, and slaughter hordes of the undead, go down to the first link in the description, download the game for free. The offer is only available right now. All right, back to the experiment. All right, guys, we are back. We've been running these filters for about 45 minutes now, to the point where the cups are actually overflowing. So let's stop for a second and observe the different results between the different filters. So just by looking at the different colors of the water here, it looks like the one on your right is actually the clearest, and this is the one that we built in this video. It's got the layer of charcoal on the bottom, the sand in the middle, the pebbles on the top, and is the pretty basic design. Now look, if we screw the cap on, we can actually contain everything inside and just set that off to the side to be used again another time. You know what else is really crazy is if you look at the top of the filter, you can actually see like the little worms, the larvae, the bugs, like jumping around and floating on top. They don't make it past the rocks though. They just stay on the top. The water we collected out of the bottom is definitely different than the water on the top. Now, the one in the middle, I'm a little bit surprised about because we actually had two different layers of charcoal and I would have expected that to be the clearest out of all of them. Now, what I think happened is when I was building this one, I actually ran out of my really fine charcoal and I just started putting in the chunky charcoal instead. So obviously it didn't filter the water quite as good as the really fine charcoal does. So this shows the finer your charcoal, the clearer your water is actually gonna be. Let's take a look down inside and check it for clarity. So I've just transferred our two large samples to two glasses so we can look inside and check for clarity. And you see the one on the left has slightly a yellow tinge to it. The one on the right though looks absolutely fantastic. And if you look down here, if you look straight through the glass, you can't see any particulates floating around whatsoever. This water right here looks beautiful. It looks refreshing, it looks crystal clear, it looks delicious in a survival situation. It's gonna be the nectar of life. However, there's one thing left to do before you drink it, and that's to sterilize it. All right, guys, I am back with my sterilized water. I just stuck this in the microwave for 4 minutes. However, there are a lot of alternative methods you could use for purifying water as well, such as water purification tablets, UV stir sticks, and I've even heard of people sticking water in clear plastic bottles and setting them out in sunlight for 24 to 48 hours. But for simplicity in this project, I went ahead and used the boiling water method. That's the method that's most commonly used, and after you boil water for a couple of minutes, it's pretty much enough to kill anything in the water that could hurt you. So they say. So here we are, guys, this is the moment of truth. We've got our green scummy pond water that we have transformed into sterilized charcoal filtered water. It's filtered, sanitized, life-giving, zero calorie, sugar-free, gluten-free, dairy-free, and ready to drink. So this is it. I'm actually so confident this is sterilized and ready to drink, I'm just gonna down the whole thing. Here we go. Bang-a-ring. That was actually really good. It tastes probably a lot different than this tastes. I mean, look, the mosquito larvae are still having a heyday in there. So in a survival situation, I choose our charcoal filter water, which is made out of materials from the backyard, dirt, sand, charcoal, and look how crystal clear that comes out. This is a viable option, guys. This is how you survive because water is one of the essentials. So there you have it, guys. That's one cool trick to taking ugly, disgusting, contaminated water and turning it into sanitized, purified, totally drinkable water. It might just save your life. Now, you guys know I post videos every single day, so if you're really curious to know whether or not this was actually safe for me to drink, click subscribe, ring the bell to receive my future post notifications, because if I stop posting, well, you'll know what happened. Thanks for joining me for this project today. If an emergency pops up, I hope this might help save your life. I'll see you in the next video. Talk to you then. I love charcoal. Except when it's in my lungs. Uh-oh. There they go, it's spilling all over the place. If you're not having a mess, you're not making fun. Hey guys, quick reminder, there's a link in the description right now to download The Walking Dead No Man's Land for free. If you download before the end of July, you'll unlock the character Negan. Go get him, boys.